ages back, we were working on something that we called the invisiball. And it was all to do with training how to hit the ball without looking at it. And it was successful, but this is what I've come up with now. So I'll let you see it. You can do that yourself. Just black out the top of the golf ball so that when you put it down, you can just see this part here. Like, hopefully you can just see the back edge of that. So that when I look at it, if I angle it like that, if I angle it like that, that's it, half and half, right? But when I'm looking down at it, I just want to see the very back edge. It looks like a crescent moon. And this is going to basically train you to, instead of looking at the whole golf ball, you're just looking at the back edge of it. Inside, outside, and middle. But it only really works when you get over the ball. And then from here, this is training you. You can hit shots with it. Like I say, you can adjust it so that you can just see it. When you're looking at it, you can just see the back edge of it. Doing is training your eyes to look at the right part of the ball. So if I want to hit a draw, I'm going to look at the inside of the ball. If I want to hit a fade, I'm going to look at the outside, and I want to hit it straight. I'm going to, what we're talking about with Ben Hogan as well, he used to always use the 45 line. Then he would swing, and he would, okay, that's the middle, and he would shuffle in. The only thing about this ball is you need to set it up every time, so that it's square and the elliptical bits right, but because the top of it's completely black, all you see is the crescent, and then from there that obviously makes it. So what we were talking about with the Hogan thing is you can move this way or this way, affect the shot. It's a circular line, hence Hogan quite liked standing open for his short irons. Quite amazing, actually. I can give myself a little bit more ball to look at here. If I angle it differently. I just did this with electrical tape. Hit into a mat, net, it's coming back to you, so. But you really can't see that I'm only seeing a tiny part of this. I'll show you what it looks like. Edit this in later. So when you're over the ball, you're seeing that or that. So it stops you getting that, which is ball dominant. You're looking at the white bit only. It's quite amazing what it does.
It's really looking at the right part of the ball,
which is this part. Come on. Catching the back of it. And if I angle it, then I can. What it will do is it will make me.
If I angle it
more like that, I'll come in more on the inside. So yeah, you can angle it so that you're concentrating. Apparently, Tiger Woods concentrates on one dimple of the golf ball. That's a true story. So he focuses his attention on one dimple. Possibly two, because let's be honest, dimples are quite small, but that's how tight his focus is. One dimple. Possibly two. Because like I say, one dimple is quite small. So, with a bit of electrical tape on your ball, you can focus in on where you're meant to be hitting on the club face. Four grooves up, really focus in, and probably the more you do it, the more you could focus in on just one dimple rather than the whole ball, which is not what you want to do. That all came from the invisiball that we did ages ago, but doing that, obscuring the ball so that you've got a tiny proportion of it, so that you know you can either see that or that or that or that. So that when you're looking at it, that's now going out and implement a fade more. Interesting. Worth pursuing, probably. Thanks for watching. Hope you found it interesting. Channel's all for charity.